Hello and welcome back. Today it happened to me. It was my first time, and my Riva exploded in my new meter. I never had this before, and I always been warned about it. Replace the Riva caps, X or Y caps, and I didn't. It didn't look that old, but apparently they just explode. And the power went out, my smoke alarm went off, but no fire, luckily. But it is a mess and it is still smelly. I have the window open. And let's see the damage that it made. Well, it happened in the power supply. You can see here, this is a little bit black, and there is a lot of dirt here on my meter here in the back. So it really exploded and also went out to the back. I tried to zoom in on that a bit more. Now maybe I better just. And it is a terrible smell. Because I was just seeing. Yeah, look, you can see here it's all dark. And oh yeah, here it happened for sure. It looks terrible. And it even blew out stuff on the front of my other meter. As you can see, it even spray on my oven here. So I will clean that also. Well, luckily it removes quite easy. I'm just using again my lotion cloths because it is very low on chemicals because it's safe for your baby. So it's probably safe for my devices. But it smells terrible. So let's see in the inside what the damage is. Okay, let's see what happened. Well, my fuse blew, so that all works. Only I hope it is not very dirty on the inside, but it is kind of, it's oily. It doesn't smell as bad as the electrolytes, but it is also not a very nice smell. And I read already you can replace it with almost any X2 or Y cap, depending of course if it is an X or a Y cap. Or you can just replace it with Rivas because they probably work at least for 20 years. So 20 years is enough. Well, you can see even though it is removed, it's still terribly brown. So I will try to do a little bit with IPA if that works or not. I just want to know. I should wear gloves. Well, it removes. Okay, that is good. Still had some spots also here. Okay, IPA works fine. Probably on the inside because it exploded on the inside. That it will be a full of dirt. Yeah, the casing, it's all black. Look at this. Yeah. And it is in the power supply area. Well, I will just clean this first, of course. Then it is done, and I have some more space on my desk. It is a pity because yesterday I fixed the display. It was looking great. So today I was doing a test just to see how long it takes to stabilize the oscillator. And someone told me, well, if you power it on, it actually, if you put in the plug and you keep it in standby because there is no real off switch, then you would see that the oscillator is heating already. So the standby is actually Well, the oscillator runs 10, and indeed I saw it was 10 or 20 watts, and I was just going to see while I was downstairs doing some video stuff, and then suddenly my internet was gone and apparently a fuse blew, and then I hear my smoke detector, so I knew something was wrong. Well, I do have a fire extinguisher here with gas, no powder. So, but it was not needed. So let's see what actually happened. I think I need to remove that one. It only seems to have one screw. I'll first have a closer look. And here you can see it's all greasy and dirty, and so it seems to have happened really on the filter side right here, not in the power supply itself. But it will give us a better view if you just open it there, and it looks to be the one in the back. The first one here is a blue one, it seems to be already replaced. But let's have a better view first. Now let's see if we can open this. Man, the smell is terrible. Yes, we can open it, and this is all clean, so it happened on the outside, yes. So it is definitely not the power supply, but the filtering. And I think we can, if I take this one out, then so we clean that. So if we unscrew this, we can take it out, and then we have a better view what actually happened. Maybe it is the filter that exploded. Yes, it is not the caps, it is the filter itself. Look, if we look in the power supply, it's spotless. If I look in the caps here in the bottom, looks good. Let me zoom in, put a little bit of light, and I try to zoom in a bit more. It doesn't seem anything wrong here. And also it doesn't, there are already newer caps. So it really looks to be the filter. And as we can see here, it is here in the back. Something exploded in here. Oh, here it does have a filter. Now I need to find one of these. Well, I'm not that familiar with Mauser, but I have here a Reichelt from Germany close by. And let's see if I can find one there somehow, but it's probably my age. But some are looking for parts in a book, because you can slide through. This is so much faster than looking on the internet. But at least I have the type numbers, and then of course I order on the internet. Well, that seemed to be a bigger challenge than I thought. It's very easy to replace, but most of them that you can find have the pins in the back like this. And then they are 5 or 6 centimeters long, while I only have 4 or actually 3 and a bit in centimeters. Yes, I have 3.5, so that's 1.5, less than 1.5 inch. So usually they are almost 2 inches usually, especially if you have those pins in the back like this. So I do need to look a little bit better, but meanwhile I can just fit in this one. If I cut the wires here, I will put the amps on here, and then at least I can use it again. And then I need to look for this filter. I will clean a little bit because it is still dirty. So I've just cut the wires, and I will just for now, I will just add the amp on here. And then it goes like this. Easy fix. Oh, it's even going to be a little bit more dirty because I have this connector, which is good. It doesn't have any filtering, but that's okay. Then I have these amp clamps, but as you can see, they are not insulated. Now, I can do it like this, but of course that is then dangerous. But then I have here my shrink. Then I put shrink around it and close it. It is really what I don't want, but I just need some more time to look on the internet to really have a filter with the wires in the bottom like this and not in the back, because then it's way, way too long. So just strip them. That's not how you strip a wire. Well, some people do. And okay. That were all three. Perfect. This is a really a nice one. Okay. Then I need three of those. Half is really too long. I do that in three. No. Then I do it in two. Well, and I find another one. Yeah, it's this one. I want to be careful with shrinking this part because it needs to go around the corner later. So. Not my best work, but it is safe with all the shrink wrap. And let's put this all back together. It should fit exactly. Well, it needed a little bit more convincement, but it is all closed. This is straight. It's all insulated here, but I really want to find the right filter. And well, we can see if it even fires up or that again my fuses blow. It's still a bit smelly. Okay, the power plug is in. It seems on standby. Yes, there it is again. So that's it. It was not too bad. It's quick and dirty, of course. I need to find the filter still, but at least I can use it. And now I need to look for it. Yeah, so my quick results didn't end up with anything. But maybe I can find somewhere on the AliExpress or the eBay. And I just start typing some of these numbers that are on it. And because they are part numbers from Fluke Philips, because when I look at looked in Google, I just came to the service manual directly. So I hope there are more general numbers also, but otherwise I just need for 1 amp. So I already saw there were also models of 3 and 10 amp, and of course they got a lot bigger also to the back. So I just need to search, but now I have time. I can use it. I just let them run the test. And thank you for watching, and hope to see you next time.